Get ready to match the stars. Bill Daly, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Ethel Merman, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Fox. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Reimers.
Thank you, one and all, for showing up here tonight and for tuning us in, too. How are you, Johnny Olson?
Great.
Good. I saw what you did, Fanny. You're a shameless woman. All right, now what we're going to do for the rest of us, the big finish. Everything's coming up roses for you and for me, all right? As Mark Breslow gets a tight shot of Fanny standing there.
Tight shot.
All right. Yes, just stand up. We'll let him get the shot now. We'll all say it. Everything's coming up
roses. Open microphones for everyone except...
All right, are you ready?
Everything's coming up roses for you and for me.
Okay.
Ethel sang it wrong.
She didn't sing it wrong. She sang that song a thousand.
I sang what you sang, and I go along with the gang.
You do. That's very nice.
Oh, really? Well, I'll be right down.
It's a match on this game.
That's right. Okay. Now, here are two players. Shall we greet them? Ron Valenti and Karen Moll there. Ron's our current champ. He got $5,600. And Ron works in a high school as an athletic director, right?
No.
No.
Wrong.
I'm wrong. Ron, no, don't tell me, Ron. Ron works, what?
Phys Ed.
Garage mechanic.
He's a garage mechanic, right. Wrong. He's a janitor in a high school.
Right.
No. Phys Ed.
Yes, sir.
Now, what's the difference between phys ed and athletic director?
And a janitor.
Athletic director is in charge of all athletics in the school.
Oh, and what do you do?
I just instruct PE.
Oh, I see. Physical, do you do all that stuff and baseball and that? Okay. Now, let's see. Karen, you had your first round question, didn't you?
Yes.
And you struck out with it, didn't you?
I sure did.
Anything about Karen, though?
No, we didn't learn too much.
What
oh, that's
Karen?
Right. Let's find out
didn't
about Karen. Well, where are you from,
I don't
Karen?
Like olives.
You don't like olives? Oh, that's right. That was a question that had to do with your appearance yesterday or whenever it was.
Yes. I'm from Boise, Idaho.
Boise, Idaho.
Yes.
Karen's from Boise, Idaho,
garage
potato
mechanic.
Country. No, she's not a garage mechanic. Are you married, Karen?
Yes, I'm married. I have three children, and I'm a house person.
You're a house person?
I'm a house person.
Really?
Good.
You're a liberated lady there. Okay. Are you booing a house person? What the heck's wrong with you? Johnny, you got a bunch of weirdos in here again. I'm not going to stand for that, John. It's your last chance. All right, listen, you get your first round question in 1 minute and 3/5 seconds. Go to black. Fade. Get out. Come on. Do what I tell you. Are we ready? Yes, we are ready. Here we go. Push a button. Reveal Ron's question. Listen carefully, Ron. This is for you. I have a TV guide listing.
Ron.
It says, Thursday night, CBS, The Waltons. Uh-huh. The Walton family kicks John Boy out when they discover that he has spent the entire summer trying to milk a blank. That's what they done to John Boy. You ever seen The Waltons?
Oh, yes. I've watched it very often.
They kicked out John Boy when they found out he spent the entire summer trying to milk a blank.
Oh.
What do you think? Don't tell me. Write your answer down there.
I'm just fast at this show.
Oh, aren't you clever?
I did these all backstage before
I
came
see.
On. I just
naturally. That's it.
Thanks for giving me all the answers.
Can I say something?
No, you cannot say anything.
Well, he does have no reference.
You two people look very chic and elegant up there.
Yeah, can we
really
stand up?
Added a lot of class.
Yes, Barbie does.
And added a lot of class to the upper tier there. Huh?
And I have Ethel's pearls on.
No, you don't have Ethel's pearls on at all.
Yes.
Her pearls are lustrous.
The same pearls. pearls.
Yours are dull.
We both have the same pearls on.
Oh, that's right, you
do. Yeah, and she has them too, but she absent-minded and left them home.
All right. All right, here we go. This is Ron's. TV Guide listing, Ron. Thursday night, CBS, The Waltons. The Walton family kicks John Boy out when they discover that he spent the entire summer trying to milk a blank.
A bull.
A bull?
A bull.
Yeah.
A bull.
He said a bull. What do you say, Bill? He said bull, Bill. What do you say, Bill?
I shouldn't have dressed up for this answer. It's so bad. Can I go and put my raunchy clothes? I said milk a joke. Because
milk a joke.
Show.
Yeah. Bob Newhart will get
turn
you for
on,
that.
Turn on, go fast, okay?
Right, Bob Newhart. Can we turn him into Bob Newhart? He'll get him
Sorry
for that, won't
that.
He?
Why?
All right, he'll give him all... What do you say?
Don't pick on him. We're engaged. He's the best I could find. I said he tried to milk a chick.
A chick. Okay. All right, Charles.
I think I'm in trouble.
Why?
Jane Boy tried to... John Boy.
You were right the first time.
I'm only upset because I blew my joke. Try to milk a Jane girl.
Oh. Take the camera off, Charles, and don't ever go back to him again. Hello, darling.
Oh.
You're up. It's your turn.
Yeah, I know. I stayed in the wrong direction. I said a steer.
Now, wait a minute. Is a steer a bull?
Yeah. Oh, it is? Yeah. Oh, I love you for that.
Turn it up. That's one for old Ron.
Yeah.
Now, how about Richard?
Heifer is a lady.
Uh-huh.
And the steer is...
Hugh Heifer? No. Oh, who is Heifer? Oh, I'm sorry.
I want you to join
Diction,
Charles.
Diction.
Oh, if I had diction, I'd be on a bigger show. Oh, anyway, I best just pop out the door. Is that a bull?
That's a bull.
That's a bull.
That's two. Okay, that's two for him. What do you offer him, Fanny, this man you adore so?
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Oh, I hope this matches. Male cow?
Male cow. Okay. Round two coming up. Karen, would you make your selection?
For my older daughter, A.
A.
Yeah.
All right, Karen, anything you say. Now, that means everybody plays because Karen didn't match anybody in the first round. Let's see
why
how she does with this.
Why didn't Karen match anybody in the first round?
Well, I don't know why. I don't remember why. Johnny Olson takes good care of himself.
Good care of himself
does
he take?
I'll tell you. First thing every morning, Johnny brushes his teeth, and then he blanks his tongue. That's
he brushes
what.
His 2 feet and
first thing every morning, Johnny brushes his teeth and then he blanks his tongue. Don't give him any clues, John. Your lips are sealed, right, John? Okay. All right. Put it in the slot. Ethel likes her answer, obviously.
I hate it.
You hate it.
I hate it.
Okay, and let's go over here to Karen Moe. You know Johnny Olson, that splendid-looking fellow standing over there. He takes good care of himself. First thing every morning, he brushes his teeth, and then he blanks his tongue.
Sharpens his tongue?
He sharpens his tongue. Okay. I guess she says he sharpens his tongue so he can talk fast and with a great deal of lucidity. What do you say, Bill?
After a heavy night of booze, I think we're close together. How about shaves his tongue?
Shaves? No. Yeah, no? I know. I know that feeling. You get that fuzzy feeling on your tongue. You got a shave feeling. You want to shave it. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, this is Tattletales we're playing, isn't
it? No.
That was the answer I gave on Tattletales. It worked. Okay.
All right, Brett.
What, dear?
They're real,
I have never had a good piece of jewelry until I met Ethel. Well, actually, it's the truth, Ethel. I want you to know that it's happened to me many a morning. I get out my Hoover and I vacuum.
You vacuum.
Yes!
Well, that's again. You see, you both got the same idea. When you get that fuzzy feeling on your tongue, you want to do something like...
When you get that fuzzy feeling.
Yes. All right, Charles.
Well, because I feel he's the greatest announcer in the business, he bronzes his tongue.
He bronzes his tongue. Now, Karen, you got to match the three lower-tier people here in order to stay in the game. And Ethel, you're up first.
Yeah.
She says, first he brushes his teeth, and then he blanks his tongue. She said sharpens.
Well, I think he would like his diction to be absolutely perfect, so I said he scrapes his tongue.
He scrapes his tongue. That's not a match, so Ron Delaney wins the game. Okay, Ace, congratulations. You've done it again. Karen, it was a pleasure meeting you.
I've really enjoyed my visit, and it's been a pleasure being in the Los Angeles.
Thank you very much. You're a sweet lady. We've got a gift for you. Karen Moe, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye. Now, she's spinning off. We'll spin this commercial for you, and then you hurry right back and see if he's going to win more money. All right, here we are waiting for you patiently, just sitting. Hello there, Ron.
Hello there.
Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Where are you from again?
Bakersfield.
Bakersfield. That's up the line a ways, isn't it?
Up the line a ways.
Yeah. What's the name of your school?
Highland High School.
Highland High School. All right, they're going to be proud of you now because I got a feeling in my bones you're going to win some money. We polled a recent studio audience. They gave us their best response to this. 21 blank.
That's my age.
And that answer the audience gave most often is $500, worth $500 if you match it. Then if you match that middle one, you collect $250. If you match a bottom one, you get $100. Three of these people are permitted to suggest answers. Whom do you call on?
Fanny.
Fanny Flagg.
Ooh.
21 blank.
Ooh. Okay, now wait a minute. 21.
21 blank.
I want to say...
What do you want to say?
Wait a minute, I want to say years old.
You want to say 21
okay,
years
here's
old?
Here's another one. 21
or over.
21.
That's your answer. 21 years old. Okay.
Okay. Years old.
That's your answer. There's one. I hope they all don't take this long.
Richard? Be testy with her?
No.
21 skidoo. That's what I would say.
Oh, it's 23 skidoo. It's 23.
Richard, I lie about my age.
23 skidoo, not 21 skidoo. You dingbat.
Well, that's what I'm going to say. I don't want him kissing me. I'm going to say 21 skidoo. Is it 23?
Can you imagine that? 23 skidoo is the old saying.
Don't you love it?
Did you think it was 21 skidoo?
Yeah.
Have you ever lied to him before?
All right. So you got 21 skidoo and 21 years old, and now you choose one more.
Well, Brett.
Brett, have you got one?
What about 21 gun salute?
Guess which one he's going to choose. All right, make up your mind now, Ron.
That's tough. 21 gun salute.
Okay.
Oh. All right. Well, when Skidoo comes up there, yeah. Pal.
If you're wrong, remember, he's a phys ed teacher. You hadn't been shaking hands with him like I have. Every time he wins a game, we have to shake hands. Holy mackerel. Okay, 21 gun salute is what we're looking for. We're going to find out if it's up there, and if so, where. May we see the $100 response?
Skidoo.
21 club. How come nobody thought of that?
I guess. I just said that.
You just said that.
That's a 23 club.
Silently.
I've been there.
I said that. Didn't I say 21?
Yep.
Pete Crindler will be very angry with all of you.
He's not around anymore.
Yes, he is.
He is? One of them is left?
Yes.
I thought they all left us.
We're not here to debate whether he's around. Let's get the skidoo.
Here is the $250 response.
21 skidoo.
21 years old. Yeah. That's Fanny's answer. See, that wasn't a bad answer at all. Last chance for 21 gun salute. Here's a $500 response. Go on. Listen, which one of them is a better kisser, Fanny or Brett? you don't have to answer that question. Now listen, you won the you won the $500. That means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. You have an actual total now of what? $6,200? $6,200. Okay. Whom do you call on here?
Richard.
I'm not surprised.
Now, wait a minute.
What does 23 Skidoo mean?
23 Skidoo is a saying that was popular in the 20s.
What does it mean? That's what I
mean. Get lost.
Get out.
Oh, well, you see, 21 Skidoo means stay here. Come on, I've got to concentrate.
All right. You're kissing Brett and kissing Fanny, but you're choosing him, eh? Okay.
That certainly says something about Ron, which I'm not at liberty to divulge.
Ron, you face me. Here we go. For $5,000. Blank language. Blank language. L-A-N-G-U-A-G-E. Language. All right, he's finished. Now, Ron, we need an answer from you. One you think will match his. What do you say to that? Blank language.
Foreign.
You say foreign language. I guess there are two ways to go on that. There's foreign language and English language. The first thing that came to my mind was English language, but I hope you're right and that you do match him, because that means you will have $11,200 if you are right. Okay, Richard, for the five G's, may we see it?
I don't want to be kissed. It's a language which is foreign.
Get back there!
I want to know about that handshake.
Isn't that handshake unbelievable?
Is this some kind of a joke?
Listen, I tell you what. His handshake is so bad, if he wins anymore, ask him to kiss you instead.
Sorry,
come right back after we get it all together here, okay? Here we go. Are you all ready? All right, let's welcome a new player. Here is Linda Cohn. How are you, Linda?
Fine.
You know Lucky here.
I know him.
He's got $11,200. All right. Linda, we'll find out about you as we go along. Why don't we just get started? Now, tell us where you're from.
I'm from California.
Okay, and we'll find out the rest of it later. That's it. Okay. Linda's from California. Make a choice here, A or B.
I'll take A.
A. All right.
Where are you from?
Bring it.
Ethel Merman at one time said, she made this statement, and I can attest to it. She said, when I sing, I work very closely with my conductor. Now, just before I have to hit a really high note, my conductor tickles my blank with his baton. She says, that's how I can hit those high notes.
She said, listen, just before I sing, the conductor tickles my blank with his baton.
Right. All right, put something down in the cards and we shall be forever grateful. Quickly, we're running out of time now. Presto, presto.
It doesn't pay.
That's right. All right.
Okay.
That's good. Very good. Charles, we're waiting for you, old bean. Put it in the slot. Here we go, Linda Cohn.
Okay.
Ethel Merman said, when I sing, I have this little system. I work very closely with my conductor. Just before I have to hit a really high note, my conductor tickles my blank with his baton.
Throat.
Throat. Very good answer. All right. She says, tickles my throat with his baton, Bill.
Little tickle throat job, I'll go with that.
All right, there he is. That's one for you, Linda. Brett, what'd you say?
If there's one thing she doesn't need tickled, it's her throat.
Oh, it is? What did you say?
You can fetch your blank. I said he tickled her little navel.
Her navel.
Oh, how darling.
That'd make her hit a high note, Charles.
He said tickle her throat and cough.
All right. That's two for you, Linda. Now, you were there.
Yes.
And what happened?
Well, my conductor always tickles my tonsils.
Tonsils and throat, there's a match. There's another one. You're doing very well, Linda. All right, Ricardo.
I missed the throat by that much.
How much?
I said derriere.
Well, yeah, but I sing facing an audience.
That's yes. Right.
Not necessarily.
Yes, I do.
All right, you're on, my dear. Cool it.
Just wanted to give the American spelling of his answer.
We'll come to you later, but right now we've got to come to this message. Pay attention, dear friends. Yes, really? I was just saying to Linda Cohen. Time is up. time is up, Ron. Okay, you'll come back next time, right?
Yes.
All right, we'll look forward to seeing both of you next time. 3-0 at this moment. Your first round question will come along later. You were all splendid. You have something to say, what?
You were very good,
too.
Oh, no,
he just drives you crazy because he doesn't understand the game yet, and we've been playing for 4 days. And he says, now, what round? Who are those people?
Yeah, say goodbye. Yeah, exactly. Gene Rayburn, Match Game 75.
Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 75. A Mark Goodson, Bill Sodden production.